Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and tonight I am going to show you lovely folks at home how to make your own custom signs, banners, paths, all that kind of stuff for Zoo Tycoon 2 in what will hopefully be a nice, simple, easy to understand tutorial. This is something I've been working on for a couple of weeks, sort of making my own stuff for Zoo Tycoon 2, and whilst there's a lot of written tutorials out there, there isn't really a lot of stuff to easily show people how to do this. You know, I struggled with this for quite a long time and how to successfully do this, and I figured a nice easy video tutorial should help people along. Now, to do this, you're only going to need three programs other than Zoo Tycoon 2. You're going to need an image editor. I recommend Photoshop if you can get hold of it. If not, then GIMP is free and online, so you can go download GIMP, and failing that, you can use Paint. But really, you should at least try to aim for GIMP, hopefully Photoshop. You're also going to need a program called DxtBMP, and you're going to need a program I'm going to load up right here called Ape2. Now, you want to download Ape2, both of those programs are free, I'll link those both down below, and you're going to load up Ape2 and it's going to look something exactly like this, hopefully. And what we're going to do here is find the files we want to edit, the file that we're going to clone into a... What Ape2 is, it basically clones an existing file, a Z2F file, which is how Zoo Tycoon packages its files, and it just changes the name into what your new file... I'll show you, you'll understand in a second, but it's very simple. So, we're going to find something to clone. I've been working on a series of signs based on the CRG sign pack, and I've done a little work on them myself already, so I'm just going to use those again. But if we go to objects, and then you can see all this stuff here. If you want to edit a path, you go on here. This is all the default paths are in there, but also the modded paths that I've sort of downloaded and added, they're all in there. If you wanted to edit one of those, it'd be super easy to do, you just click one. But follow through with me, we're going to go into scenery, and I'm going to edit one of my own things. So I'm going to edit Bis Sign Ceratosaurus, which is obviously the sign for our Ceratosaurus paddock. So, let's pretend that I don't have hiccups. Let's pretend that we're going to make a sign for our upcoming, in our next episode, Diplodocus exhibit. So, in this little bottom bit next to clone into project, we would type Bis. It actually annoys me that I've done that double thing with the S, but whatever. Bis sign Diplodocus, like so. You do this no matter what. You know, if you're cloning a path, do this. Call it maybe like a little sign for yourself. I start all mine with BIS. A lot of people start their files with ZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZZ popular thing, but again, it seems stupid to me, but whatever. I'm going to start all mine with BIS. Start it with whatever. Just give it a unique name that you know you're going to be able to recognize. So I'm going to sort of duplicate that. We're going to click the clone into project button right there. And then you can see it up here now. Boop, Biff signed Diplodocus. You can go in here, change properties and Zoopedia and all this kind of stuff if you want to add fun facts about your sign, blah, 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 blah. We don't really care about that right now. We're just going to save Z2F. And we're going to save it into the desktop for now. And get rid of the Z there. There we go. Save. And that should work. Yes, there we go. So there we have BIS. Bis-sign Diplodocus. So that right there is basically a direct copy of my existing Ceratosaurus sign, but everything has been changed to the word Diplodocus instead. So this looks like a zip file, but it's actually a Z2F file. You open these up with WinZip or 7-Zip or whatever program you use. I'm going to go ahead and open this up right now so you guys can see what we're working with. Let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so you'll end up with something like this. You should have entities lying UI. You might have other stuff depending on what you've cloned. But let's say you're cloning the same stuff as me. You're working from CRG Sign Pack 2. This is the kind of thing you should have. Now, I've got to address this very quickly. I can't release these files. And what I can do is release my own personal designs, like this little bit here. I can release that. That's fine. In terms of the completed mods, that's not something I can give out. And if you're working on other people's files, because what I'm doing here is modding other people's work, you can't give that out either. Because at the end of the day, you don't own the files, it's other people's stuff. They modeled it, all we're doing is some basic texture changes. And the point is for it to be our own personal enjoyment rather than something you redistribute, just making sure. Anyways, you'll end up with something like this. If you go into Entities, Objects, Scenery, you'll see it's now called Bis-sign Diplodocus. That would have been called Ceratosaurus in the original file. Load that up. All the files here have had their name changed, but you'll see the actual look of the image. You can just see it there, it's still the Ceratosaurus sign. So all it's done is change the name of the file in all the different locations. If we go back to Lang, I believe, yep, it's done it there, and it'll do it inside the documents as well. And the same in the UI as well. Everything's just had its name changed. It basically duplicates the file, gives it a new name. So if I install this into the game now, we'd have two identical signs in the game. one called Bis Sign Diplodocus, one called Bis Sign Ceratosaurus, but they would both look like a Ceratosaurus sign. Deep breath. We're halfway there. So we've got our file, we've got our modified file copied, ready to work on. This is where DXTBMP comes in. We're going to load this up. We're going to go to File, Open. We're going to go to Desktop. We're going to find Desktop. There it is. Going to make sure there's nothing dodgy on that page. No, we're okay. And we're going to load up our unzipped. You want to make sure you've unzipped this first. We're going to load up our unzipped BIS sign Diplodocus. Go into Entities, Objects, Scenery, and load up the image here. This is this first one here. You don't really need to worry about these. You can worry about this, I'll show you that in a second, but we're going to just load this up. Should load up the texture and you'll have something that looks like this, depending on what it is you are editing. Now, what we're going to do is send this to our editor. You can change which editor it goes to. By default, mine went to Paint. And you'll see here there's a button here in the top left, Reset Editor to MS Paint. Now, for most of us, that isn't very useful, so you want to go to Prefs, you want to go to Select Editor, you want to go into your programs, you want to find Photoshop or whatever it is you're using. Then when you click Image Send to Editor, boop, and it loads up in Photoshop. And this is the BMP file that we're going to work with. Now, thankfully, I already have my PSD file. Like I said, I might release this out to you guys if you guys want to use this. It's nothing special, but let's say we're just going to make that Diplodocus. I'm not going to worry too much about everything else. Let's just copy that image there. I'm going to paste that into there, and I'm going to put that over the top. Now, when this goes into game, if it's that size, it does actually cut off a little bit, so all I've been doing is resizing it a little bit like so. So all we do is paste that over there. So, I feel like I did that maybe a little bit too fast. To go through that a little slower, we opened up the file, well, we sent the editor from DXTBMP, and then you want to work on, just work on the file. You could work directly on this. You know, if I wanted to, or if all I wanted to do was put a smiley face onto this, all we'd have to do is this. Blah, blah, blah. Let's do that. That's fine. There we go. We've got our smiley face. That's all we want to do. If you want to do more complicated stuff, if you maybe want to add like a little fancy sign like this, I recommend working in a separate document like I've done here. You know, I've built like a little PSD file. Save that as a PSD and then you can keep working on it in the future. Flatten it down with layer, merge visible, copy and paste it over into BMP. At the end of the day, I don't really want to explain how to use Photoshop to you guys. But anyone who knows how to use Photoshop, or if you use some Paint or GIMP or whatever, this should all make relative amounts of sense. So the important thing you want to do now, make sure you flatten this. This BMP, you can see it's called Norm BMP up here on the top. This has to be a flat layer. It will cause you problems if not, and you're going to hit Control S. You have to just hit Control S. If you save as, you'll mess things up. Just hit Control S for save. The reason we flatten this is if you have multiple layers and you try to Control S, it will Control Save As, which is what we're trying to avoid. If you now load up, once you've saved that, if you go back to DXTBMP, you'll see it's still the same. We go to Image, we go to Reload After Edit, and if this has been done right, that should now be a Diplodocus, and there should be a big smiley face. Ta-da! There we go, lovely jubbly. That's pretty much done. So what we're going to do now is File, Save, and we're going to just replace all of these. The only reason there's multiple here for this one is because this sign, a lot of this stuff in Zoo Tycoon 2, particularly mods, will change if you put them down. So let's say you've got a conservation sign. If you keep putting that sign down, it'll load up different files, and that's pretty much how this works. The original images are all different languages. So you can put a sign down, it'd be English. You put the same sign down again, it might turn out in Russian or whatever. I don't know if you need to keep all three of these, but I do it just in case, to be honest. I don't pretend to be professional at this. I just want to show you guys how it works. So all we're doing is replacing the files. They've already got the right name. They're already called Diplodocus because of the thing we did with Ape 2. So you want to replace all three of these. Now, if you want to change the icon that you see in Zoo Tycoon 2, we do the exact same thing. We load in the different file here, which is called Bisign Diplodocus icon, and we'd send it to editor and we'd edit it. This does look a little weird in game because there's an alpha channel here from the sign, like so. And to be honest, I don't really know much about the alpha channel. Like, I don't know how to do the alpha channel. So maybe in the future I can give you guys a different tutorial on that. But basically you load that up, send to editor, edit it, and you'll be able to change your little sign. It does turn out looking a little weird because I don't know about editing the alpha channels. But at the end of the day, guys, this is not important stuff. This is stuff we can deal with. So we're going to close this down. I'm going to close down Photoshop. And if we now load our unzipped file, we should delete, we don't need that. Our unzipped file, double click that, entities, objects, scenery, bits and diplodocus, you can now see there's a smiley face on all three sides. So now, no matter how many times you click that sign in game, it should turn out as the same file, it should say diplodocus, and it should have a big smiley face. That's pretty much good to go. The only thing we need to do now is open that up, select our entities lying at UI, right click, we're going to add to archive. This is really important you do this exactly like I'm showing you guys right now. We're going to change that to a zip file in archive format, and we're going to get rid of .zip at the end, and we're going to change that to Z2F. Lovely jubbly. And that right there is our finished, completed mod. That right there, look at that, beautiful. We don't need that anymore either. Now, one of the things I was doing wrong, personally, when I first started this, was, bloody Nora, I was zipping up this here, rather than zipping up those three files. Basically, if you unzip the final mod, it should go straight to entities lying UI. If it goes to a second folder first, then that's why it's not working. You should unzip it, and you should be given those three files right there. Shut up, world! So, we're gonna cut that. We're gonna go into Zoo Tycoon 2. We're going to paste, boop, there it is, beside the Plodicus. And now I'm going to load up the game and hopefully show you guys that this has worked and that I'm not a complete idiot. Okay, we're in-game now, we've loaded up onto our scenery tab and pretty optimistic because as you can see, we now have two files off that sign, both called Ceratosaurus sign because it has been renamed in something else, I don't know, I probably forgot to rename it somewhere. But either way, both called Ceratosaurus sign, that is our default Ceratosaurus sign we use in-game. Like so. And if we click this one over here, don't know why it's called Ceratosaurus sign. Need to edit some. Ah, there's some information in one of the. Yeah, there's information you need to find. We're not going to worry about that right now. That stuff doesn't matter. But if we click that there, as you can see, the finished Diplodocus sign is in game with a big old smiley face. Obviously, I'm not for a second going to profess to be amazing at this. This is something I'm very new to. It's very basic stuff. There's obviously some issues. You know, I don't really know alpha channels. All this kind of stuff, which I'm sure is very simple, but I really just wanted to get you guys out there making your own signs, getting them into the game, because honestly, it makes such a big difference to how your park feels. To give you a quick look, there's a Jurassic Jungle sign. That was a custom sign we made. That brings you down here. La-da-da-da-da. We go to the right, we go up the stairs, and there is our Ceratosaurus sign, right outside our Ceratosaurus paddock. It brings this whole unique element, and there's a lot of stuff I don't know about it, but it's something I'm very interested to learn down the line. Hopefully when I can sort out alpha channels, the information, maybe texturing animals and stuff, I'm going to do a second tutorial for you guys at home, and hopefully maybe down the line we'll do some modelling and stuff like that as well. But the important thing is, go make custom signs, bring your own creations into the Zoo Tycoon 2 world, and I'd love to see what you guys can make. Thank you for joining me. If you have any questions whatsoever, don't hesitate to ask in the comments down below. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, yes, for more Zoo Tycoon 2 content, and park content, and it's JPOG and all that stuff, it's very exciting. Thanks for joining me, cheers, much love, as always, bye-bye.